Good morning students, this is the second part of my previous video in which I will discuss the subject English of UPPSC GIC lectures exams held on 23rd September 2018. Okay, now let's start. Question number 31. Choose the correct option among the following. So the correct option is B. Blank verse is poetry written with regular metrical but unrhymed lines, almost always in iambic pentameter. So B option, blank verse has meter but no rhyme, will be correct. Question number 32. The bound morpheme ness is used to make. Here bound morphemes play an important role by adding the bound morpheme ness to the adjective, we can change it into a noun. So the right option will be D, a noun. Question number 33. A metrical foot consisting of an unstressed syllable followed by a stressed syllable is. Here dactyl is a metrical foot consisting of one accented syllable followed by two unaccented. And B option, that is iambic, is a metrical foot consisting of an unstressed syllable followed by a stressed syllable. And C option, that is trochee, is a metrical foot consisting of a stressed syllable followed by an unstressed syllable. So the right option will be B, iambic, which is a metrical foot consisting of an unstressed syllable followed by a stressed syllable. Okay, let's see question number 34. Which of the following poems is written in terza rima? So the poem Ode to the West Wind consists of five sections, cantos, written in terza rima. Each section consists of four tercets, ABA, BCB, CDC, DAD, and a rhyming couplet EE. The ode is written in iambic pentameter. So the right option will be A, Ode to the West Wind. Question number 35. Point out the figure of speech in the following. To err is human, to forgive divine. So the right option is A, antithesis. To err is human, to forgive divine is said by Alexander Pope. The figure of speech used here is antithesis. So let me explain what is antithesis. Antithesis is a figure of speech which refers to the juxtaposition of opposing or contrasting ideas. Okay. Now let's see question number 36. Name the figure of speech in the following. He passed a sleepless night. So here the right option is C, transferred epithet. In this figure of speech, an epithet is transformed from its proper word to another that is closely associated with that in the sentence. So right option is C. Question number 37. Fill in the blanks with appropriate preposition. His house is dash Church Street. So the right option will be D, his house is in Church Street. Question number 38. Fill in the blanks with appropriate preposition. My friend accommodated me alone. So the right preposition will be with, which is given in option B. My friend accommodated me with a loan. Question number 39. Choose the correctly spelled word. So the correctly spelled word is given in option B. Habits, H-A-B-I-T-S. Question number 40. Choose the correctly spelled word. So here the correctly spelled word is given in option D, that is agreement, A-G-R-E-E-M-E-N-T. Question number 41. Choose the correctly spelled word. Here the correctly spelled word is given in option B, that is intellect, I-N-T-E-L-L-E-C-T. Question number 42. Choose the correctly spelled word. Here the correctly spelled word is given in option A, that is nectar, N-E-C-T-A-R. Question number 43. Choose the correctly spelled word. Here the correctly spelled word is given in option B, that is rhythm, R-H-Y-T-H-M. Question number 44. Give one word for the following. The fact of being the first child born in a family. So the one word will be primogeniture. Here primogeniture means the state of being the first born child. So option C will be correct here. Question number 45. Give one word for the following. A hospital for people who are dying. So the one word will be hospice, which is given in option B. H-O-S-P-I-C-E. Hospice. Question number 46. Give the synonym of imperative. So the synonym of imperative will be vital, V-I-T-A-L, which is given in option A. Question number 47. Give the synonym of percipient. So the synonym of percipient will be perceptive, which is given in option B. So the right option will be B. Question number 48. Give the synonym of pusillanimous. So the synonym for pusillanimous will be cowardly, which is given in option B. Okay, question number 49. Give the antonym of sailor. So here the antonym of sailor will be attic, that is given in option D, A-T-T-I-C. Here sailor means in Hindi tahkhana and attic means in Hindi atari. Question number 50. Use prefix to the word bitter. Here the right prefix will be E-M. So it will become embitter, which is given in option A. So right option will be A. Question number 51. Transform the following sentence into an affirmative sentence. Your options are as below. So the right option is B. Old fools surpass all other fools in folly. Now question number 52. Who first used the term sprung rhythm in prosody? So sprung rhythm an irregular system of prosody developed by the 19th century English poet Gerard Manley Hopkins. So right option will be C. Now question number 53. Which epithet cannot be applied to Robert Frost poetry? So the right option is B. Neoclassical. Question number 54. Wessex refers to, here the right option will be C. The region in which Hardy's novels are set. Now question number 55. Which of the following is a novel by Raja Rao? So the right option is D. Comrade Krillo. Question number 56. Gitanjali by Tagore is a collection of, here the correct option is D. 103 songs. Question number 57. What kind of character is Major Sergius in Arms and the Man? So the right option is C. Romantic. Question number 58. In his love poems, W.B. Yeats has celebrated the beauty of, here the right option is B. Maud Gonne. Question number 59. Lucetta is a character in Hardy's. The right option is C. The Mayor of Casterbridge. Question number 60. Which novel of Charles Dickens is highly autobiographical? So David Copperfield, having autobiographical elements, is the 8th novel by Charles Dickens. The novel's full title is The Personal History. It was first published as a serial in 1849 to 1850 and as a book in 1850. So the right option is A. David Copperfield. Question number 61. Tennyson's poem In Memoriam was composed to commemorate the death of, here the right option is C. Arthur Hallam. Question number 62. Arnold's Empedocles on Etna is, here the right option is B. Melodramatic poem. Question number 63. T.S. Eliot propounds the impersonal theory of poetry in, here T.S. Eliot's essay The Tradition and Individual Talent was published in the year 1919, in which his views on impersonality of the artist first appeared. So the right option will be D. Tradition and the Individual Talent. Okay, let's see question number 64. Change the given sentence into indirect form of speech. So the right indirect form will be, he told me that he didn't believe me, or you can say, he said he didn't believe me. So here option B will be correct. He said he didn't believe me. Okay, question number 65. Fill in the blanks in the given sentence, choosing the correct option. The cat sprang the table. Here the right preposition will be upon. The cat sprang upon the table. So option A is correct. Question number 66. Fill in the blanks with appropriate words from the list given below the sentence. I don't have a piece of chalk, so I dash write on the blackboard. So correct preposition will be can't, which is given in option C. I don't have a piece of chalk, so I can't write on the blackboard. Question number 67. Fill in the blanks with appropriate words from the list given below the sentence. They dash have received our letter by now. So appropriate word will be should. They should have received our letter by now. So option B will be correct. Question number 68. Fill in the blanks with appropriate word from the list given below the sentence. When I was young, I dash read without glasses. So the right word will be would. When I was young, I would read without glasses. So option C will be correct. Question number 69. The phrase on and off means, here the right option will be D, intermittently. Question number 70. Point out the figure of speech. Yonder comes the powerful king of day, rejoicing in the east. Here the figure of speech used in this line is C, that is personification. Question number 71. Choose the correctly spelled word. Here correctly spelled word is given in option C, that is atheism, A-T-H-E-I-S-M. In Hindi it means Anishwarvad. Question number 72. One word substitution. A man with abnormal habits. So here arrogant means in Hindi Abhimani, egoist in Hindi it means Ahangvadi, and septic it means in Hindi Shankarshil Vyakti. So option D will be correct, that is eccentric. So a man with abnormal habits can be called as eccentric. Okay, let's see question number 73. The correct meaning of the idiom not to see eye to eye is, here not to see eye to eye means not to agree with someone or not to share someone's position or opinion. So the right option will be A, disagree. Question number 74. Identify the correctly spelled word. Here the correctly spelled word is given in option B, avant-garde. In Hindi it means aggressor, and in English it means radically new or original. So right option is B. Question number 75. Identify the correctly spelled word. Here correctly spelled word is given in option A, that is vivisection. It means the act of operating on living animals, especially in scientific research. So option A is correct here. Question number 76. Identify the correctly spelled word. Here, correctly spelled word is given in option B, that is phlegmatic. In Hindi, it means shant chitta. And in English, it means showing little emotion. Question number 77. Identify the correctly spelled word. Here, correctly spelled word is given in option C, that is horizontal. In Hindi, it means chhatis. And in English, it means parallel to the plane of the horizon at right angles to the vertical. Question number 78. Fill in the blanks in the following sentence with an appropriate preposition given below the sentence. Although we requested him to help us, he remained indifferent our words. So right preposition will be to, which is given in option D. Although we requested him to help us, he remained indifferent to our words. Question number 79. Fill in the blanks in the given sentence with an appropriate preposition. W.B. Yeats was nominated a senator of the Irish Free State on the ground that he had been a member of the Irish Republican Brotherhood, one of the main forces dash the treaty. So right preposition will be here behind, which is given in option B. The main forces behind the treaty. It will be the right expression. Question number 80. Fill in the gap in the given sentence with an appropriate preposition. Language is a verbal communication, but we communicate dash other means also. So the right preposition will be here with. Language is a verbal communication, but we communicate with other means also. Okay, so option A will be correct here. Question number 81. Identify the figure of speech used in the following lines. How soon hath time, the subtle thief of youth, stole on his wings my 23rd year. So the right option is D, metaphor. John Milton's How Soon Hath Time includes metaphors and some alliteration, though metaphor is the more dominant literary device in this poem. Milton primarily uses metaphor to describe the passage of time and the process of aging. Okay, so the right option will be D, metaphor. Question number 82. Correct the following sentence. Newton discovered that the force of gravitation made apples fall. So the correct sentence will be, Newton discovered that the force of gravitation makes apples fall. Because universal truth are always in simple present tense. So this will be also in present tense. Here option D will be correct. Question number 83. Add right suffix to repent. Here the right suffix for this word repent will be repentant. A-N-T, that is given in option B. Question number 84. Add right prefix to bold. So right prefix will be E-M and it will become imbold. So option A will be correct. Question number 85. Give the correct antonym for acquit. So correct antonym will be convict, which is given in option A. Question number 86. Choose the correct meaning of the idiom put out in the following sentence. He was put out when I refused his request for a loan. So here right option will be A, vexed, V-E-X-E-D. Question number 87. Select the word or phrase that is most closely opposite in meaning to the word timid. So here the correct option is B, bold. The opposite meaning of timid will be bold. Question number 88. Select the word which is most closely opposite in meaning to admonition. So here admonition means in Hindi chetavani. So the opposite meaning will be request, that is given in option D. Question number 89. Give the antonym of says. Here says means in Hindi buddhiman, or we can say jnani, wise. So antonym of says will be fool, which is given in option A. Question number 90. Give antonym of moist. So your right option is C, dry. Question number 91. Who wrote the essay entitled On the Knocking at the Gate in Macbeth? So your right option is D, Thomas D. Quincy. Question number 92. Which of the following poems is not composed in ballad form? So here the poem Lycidas, written by John Milton in 1637 as a pastoral elegy. So this poem Lycidas is not written in ballad form. So your correct option will be C. Who has originally composed the line Sweet Thames run softly till I end my song? So these lines are written in the poem Prothalemian by Edmund Spenser. So right option will be D, Edmund Spenser. Question number 94. Who propounded the concept of esemplastic imagination in English literature? So in the Biographia Literaria, Coleridge has a chapter titled On the Imagination or Esemplastic Power. So the right option will be C, Samuel Taylor Coleridge. Question number 95. In which year was the book Biographia Literaria published? So Biographia Literaria was originally published in 1817. So right option will be A. Let's see question number 96. Which of the following terms has been defined as it dissolves, diffuses, dissipates in order to recreate? So it's about Coleridge's secondary imagination. So the right option will be B, imagination. Question number 97. Matthew Arnold's The Study of Poetry was published in. So here I think no option is correct, as The Study of Poetry by Matthew Arnold was published in 1888. So I don't find that date here and the year. 1888. So I think here no option will be correct. Question number 98. The correct title of Shelley's poem is, here the right option is A, To a Skylark. Question number 99. A sense sublime of something far more deeply interfused. The words given above occur in, so a sense sublime of something far more deeply interfused. These lines occur in the poem from lines composed a few miles above Tintern Abbey on revisiting the banks of the Wye during tour July 13, 1798 by William Wordsworth. So the right option will be D, Tintern Abbey. Let's see question number 100. The necessity of atheism was written by, here the right option is B, Shelley. Question number 101. Which of the following poems is not an elegy? So here the poem Break, 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 Lycidas and Thyrsis are elegy, and the poem Prospice, which is given in option C, is not an elegy, so option C will be correct. Now question 102. Stanley Weber in the birthday party is, here the right option is A, pianist. Question number 103. The twin brother of Viola in Twelfth Night is, here the correct option is B, Sebastian. Question number 104. Which among the following was not written by Rabindranath Tagore? Here the right option is C, the Bachelor of Arts. Question number 105. In which book of Mulk Raj Anand, Bakha is the central character? So here right option is B, Untouchable. Question number 106. For which work was Ernest Hemingway awarded the Nobel Prize? So Ernest Hemingway was awarded the Nobel Prize for his novel The Old Man and the Sea in 1954. So right option will be C. Question number 107. Which among the following is a play not written by Girish Kanrad? So here the play Sacrifice is written by John Galsworthy. So the right option will be here A, Sacrifice, which is not written by Girish Kanrad. Question number 108. The function of criticism at the present time was written by, here the right option is C, Matthew Arnold. Let's see question number 109. Who said Donne affects the metaphysics not only in his satires but in his amorous verses? So it was said by John Dryden. Here option A will be correct. Question number 110. Which among the following was not composed by P.B. Shelley? So the Revolt of Islam, Prometheus Unbound, The Cenci are written by P.B. Shelley, and Lamia was written by John Keats. So here the correct option will be D. Question number 111. Which phrase was not coined by T.S. Eliot? So objective correlative, unification of sensibility and dissociation of sensibility are coined by T.S. Eliot, and the negative capability is coined by John Keats. So here Option A will be correct, negative capability. Question number 112. Tennyson won the Chancellor's Medal at Cambridge on his poem. Here, option C, Timbuktu, will be correct option. Question number 113. The line, hearts are not had as a gift, but hearts are earned, appears in W.B. Yeats' poem. Here the right option is B, A Prayer for My Daughter. Question number 114. The rest is silence. These are the last words spoken before his death. Who is the speaker? So these words were spoken by Hamlet. So option D will be correct. Question number 115. Chaucer's prologue to the Canterbury Tales opens with a description of the month of. Here option C will be correct, April. Question number 116. Which play of Shakespeare has an epilogue in it? So here the right option is A, The Tempest. Question number 117. Dryden's The Hind and the Panther, 1687, is written in defense of. Here the right option is B, Roman Catholic faith. Question number 118. Who made the following remark? If Pope be not a poet, where is poetry to be found? So here the right option is C, Dr. Johnson. Question number 119. The term Renaissance means. Here option B is correct, rebirth of classical learning. Question number 120. The prelude of Wordsworth consists of. Here option C, 14 books will be correct option. Question number 121. Aristotle's concept peripeteia means. Here option A, reversal of the situation will be correct option. Question number 122. Find out the correct sentence among the following. Here the correct sentence is, I am fond of reading fiction. So here option C will be correct option. Question number 123. Change the following into indirect narration. The teacher said to the boy, go away from your class. So the correct indirect narration form is given in option B. The teacher ordered the boy to go away from his class. Option B is correct here. Question number 124. Change the following into passive voice. He can read English and French. So the right passive form is given in option D. English and French can be read by him. Question number 125. Give the synonyms of childlike. Here synonym of childlike will be childish. So here option A will be correct. Question number 126. Give the antonym of naughty. Here the right antonym of naughty is easy. So option B will be correct option. Question number 127. supply the suitable preposition in the following sentence. The book lies dash the table. So here the correct preposition will be on. The book lies on the table. Question number 128. Use the proper idiomatic phrase in the following sentence. The rebels dash their arms. So the right idiomatic phrase will be here, let down. So option B will be correct. The rebels let down their arms. Question number 129. Supply the proper prefix to qualify. So the proper prefix will be DIS and it will become disqualify. So option B will be correct here. Question number 130. Which of the following express the meaning of a red letter day? So here option C is correct. An important and happy day in one's life. Question number 131. Who wrote the poem Absalom and Achitophel? So this poem was written by John Dryden. Here option A will be correct. Question number 132. The Dunciad was written by, here option C, Alexander Pope will be the correct option. Question number 133. Mrs. Warren's Profession was written by, here the option D, that is G.B. Shaw, will be correct option. Question number 134. Shakespeare's Measure for Measure is a, here option A, dark comedy is the correct option. Question number 135. Which of the following is considered as P.B. Shelley's masterpiece? So here Prometheus Unbound is considered as P.B. Shelley's masterpiece. So option D will be correct here. Question number 136. Who wrote the following lines? Men may come and men may go, but I go on forever. So these lines are taken from the poem The Brook, written by Alfred Lord Tennyson. So here option B will be correct option. Okay, now let's see question number 137. Asia is a character in, so Asia is a character in Shelley's Prometheus Unbound. Who is Prometheus' wife? So here option A will be correct. Shelley's Prometheus Unbound. Question number 138. Who is the author of Culture and Anarchy? So here option C, Matthew Arnold is the correct option. Question number 139. Who declared himself to be a classicist in literature, a royalist in politics, and an Anglo-Catholic in religion? So here the option D is correct, T.S. Eliot. T.S. Eliot pronounced himself as classicist in literature, royalist in politics, and Anglo-Catholic in religion. Okay, let's see next question. Question number 140. The theme of Ezekiel's poetry is, here option B will be correct, life in the city. Question number 141. From where does the Lady of Shalott see the world around her? Here the correct option is B, a mirror. Question number 142. Who pronounced Dryden as the father of modern English criticism? So here option C is correct, Dr. Johnson. Question number 143. Which Shakespeare's play has a mosque in it? So The Tempest not only has a mosque with gods and goddesses dancing in a performance for a prince and princess, but the whole play can be seen as a mosque with much of the story told in music and song. So here the right option will be C, The Tempest. Choose the word opposite in meaning to zenith. Here the correct opposite word of zenith will be nadir, that is given in option B. So nadir will be correct option. Now let's see question number 145. Choose the word opposite in meaning to asyl. So asyl in Hindi means phurtila, and here the opposite word will be slow. So option B will be correct here. Question number 146. Choose the word nearest in meaning to heathen. So the nearest word will be infidel, which means adhering to a religion other than that of the majority. So here option C will be correct option. Question number 147. Choose the word nearest in meaning to Holocaust. Here Holocaust means in Hindi Sarvanash. So here the option A, annihilation. Annihilation means complete destruction or obliteration. So here correct option will be A, annihilation. Okay, let's see question number 148. Which word is opposite in meaning to hypothetical? Here hypothetical means parikalpit, so the opposite word will be actual. So here option C will be correct option, actual. Question number 149. Choose the word nearest in meaning to impasse. Here impasse in Hindi it means gatirodh. So correct nearest word will be deadlock. Question number 150. Choose the word nearest in meaning to invincible. So here the nearest word will be unconquerable, which is given in option D. So here option D will be correct option. Okay students, this was all about the KIC lectures exam question paper. Due care has been taken while preparing the solution of the question paper. In spite, if you find any discrepancy regarding the answers, please intimate me with question number, so that I may do the needful and respond to you at the earliest. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.